Welcome back to Fox and Friends. Over 140 Christians were killed in Nigeria by jihadists over the Christmas holiday, marking another deadly weekend in West Africa as Christians are practically being hunted for sport. And while the world looks the other way, Nigeria was marked the worst country in the world for Christian persecution last year, according to the International Christian Concern. Here to react, President of the Congress of Christian Leaders, Reverend John Moore. Reverend, thank you for joining us on this very important and very underreported story. So from my understanding of the stats, a Christian is killed every 2 hours in Nigeria. It's astounding. Why don't you just tell us what is going on? Why are Christians being hunted down and killed and kidnapped and their churches burned in Nigeria specifically?
Well, first of all, it depends on who you ask. If you ask the Christian community in Nigeria, and this is the largest country in Africa, the biggest economy in Africa, a democracy nonetheless, that's basically 50% Christian, 50% Muslim, and every single Christian in the country will tell you they're being targeted because they're Christians.
Right.
And the unmentionable things are happening to women. Children are being killed in grotesque ways. Every church they can find is being burned down. Whole villages being burned down. It is basically 100 times worse than anything you've seen. In fact, you know, the 140 people that were killed over Christmas, since that happened, over the last week, another 4 villages have been annihilated entirely. So if you ask the Christians, they say we're being targeted because we're Christians. They want to ethnically, religiously cleanse us. If you ask the Department of State, they're going to say this has nothing to do with religion. In fact, just this last week, the Department of State reversed yet again a Trump administration decision to designate Nigeria as one of the world's foremost persecutors of religious people, of Christians, because they believe the reason why this is happening is, wait for it, climate change.
Yes, I saw that. I saw that in the AP. My colleague Pete Hegseth showed me the article where the AP said this is happening because of climate change. It's absolutely astounding, first of all, that the Trump administration first designated Nigeria, rightfully so. They called it the worst violator, Nigeria, the worst violator of religious freedom in the world. And just as 140 Christians were massacred over Christmas, and we know 52,000 in Africa since 2009 have been killed, now the Biden administration just this month decides to reverse that, and now the media and the State Department are saying it's climate change. Why are they, is it that they're pushing climate change and they're trying to, you know, take these tragedies and push their agenda? Or is there something else that they don't want to in any way implicate Muslims or somehow downplay the conditions? Why would they want to downplay the conditions and the brutality against Christians?
It's a combination of things. I mean, one is that. One is the fact that plenty of Muslims around the world are blinking red lights in saying that there's a piecemeal ISIS-like caliphate being formed in Western Africa. And by the way, the whole of the African continent's in trouble. You have a civil war in Sudan. You have basically a line of coups all across the continent. And in the Western side, you have these jihadist organizations that are forming. And by the way, Nigeria, which is the biggest, most powerful country, is a country we, the United States government, our taxpayer dollars,
right,
gives $1 billion a year to. And so, you know, but also it's unfortunately, this Department of State doesn't have much to show for anything. I mean, we have the worst hostage crisis in modern American history. We have more Americans killed by terrorists since 9/11. We have the Afghan withdrawal. We have, you know, war in Israel, war in Ukraine, civil war in Sudan. I mean, the list just goes on and on and on. And, you know, when you look at these things, you say, like, is someone on vacation?
Right.
And what we found out, you know, at the beginning of the show today is actually the president was on vacation. Deputy Secretary of Defense was on vacation. The Secretary of Defense was in the ICU. I mean, it's like insane. It's insane what's happening.
You know, Our government is being blind to this, the media is too, but there aren't enough Catholic and Christian leaders like yourself out there bringing attention to it. We really thank you for doing that, and we hope others will continue to speak for the plight of those Christians in Africa. Thank you for joining us, Reverend. Really appreciate it.